What's up, everybody? Once again, it's Brand Man Sean, and this is a quick little video I got to do, and it's about a serious topic, gang culture. And of course, when I mean gang culture, I'm talking about this gang culture that all these artists are trying to create when they say gang, 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 I'm this gang, I'm that gang, I'm that gang, because they want to give their fan base a name. This used to not be a thing back in the day, but now it is, especially because of the internet and people can make up these hashtags, and doing it as a hashtag makes them think that just because I did it, now my fan base is all bought in, but that is not the case. I know Rihanna has the Navy, Beyonce has the Beehive, and Barb's for Nicki Minaj, and J. Cole, I don't know what J. Cole has. If somebody knows what J. Cole has, put that in the comment section. Like, that would be interesting. So the first thing that people gotta realize is, one, you do not need to have a name for your fan base to be a very strong fan base. There just needs to be an understood culture and a pure joy and love for whoever the artist is. If you really want your fan base to create a relation and culture, then you have to think about that community, building a community. You can check out my video on lifestyle branding, where I talk about Starbucks, weed, and Travis Scott to really dig in on how to create a community. Because here's the truth. So many people have these hashtag gang, hashtag this gang, that gang, and whatever other these weird names people got going on, that the fans, they're not a part of any of them. They don't care about your gang, and it's not necessarily because they don't care about you. It's just the fact that, how does a gang work? If I love five different artists, which means I got five different gangs that I'm a part of, am I really a part of a gang at all? Because, you know, that's kind of against the point, right? But that's really what's happening from a consumer fan base perspective. They're not thinking about it consciously a lot of times, but what you're seeing is less interest. You might see people use it here and there, but they don't really feel any buy-in where they really feel like they're repping for, you know, whatever you got going on. They love you as an artist, but this label isn't something that they identify with strongly. I mean, that's something to really think about, because how would you feel about somebody if they told you they were a Blood and a Crip and a GD, Democrat, Republican, liberal, Taylor Swift fan? You would probably look at that person like they were crazy, like, bruh, like, pick one. So again, focus less on the name itself. The name is not going to do the job for you. Focus on creating the community and the deeper connection. And that community, once again, is not necessarily about you. It's about creating this relationship between everybody else who happens to follow you. You're just an ambassador for that community. For a perfect example, there's a guy that I've been watching random YouTube videos of his lately, and he always says swim team. What up, swim team? So the people who are following him, he's calling them the swim team. And he says that because he has those waves in his hair and everything, and everybody might not really relate to that in the audience, everybody who's just watching his videos, because you have an array of people if you got a lot of followers. But at the end of the day, there's probably a lot of people out there who do connect with the fact that he has waves. They probably have waves too. And, because of that, they identify with the term swim team and might use it a lot more willingly than a lot of these other fan bases that might not necessarily even be about the artist, influencer, or whoever. Because at the end of the day, if you think about a term like swim team that's applying to people who have waves in their hair, they don't have to even like the guy to feel like they're a representative or a part of that community. A lot of people are afraid to create something that exists without their involvement, but a lot of times if you can do that, you're creating a lot more power for yourself from a brand perspective and a lot more opportunity, because that brand will be able to do things that your brand can't do without it losing value. Just something to think about. Would love to know you guys' thoughts as always. If you like this video, go ahead and hit the like button. If you like it, you might as well share it. And if you're not subscribed, you know what to do. Hit that subscribe button.